Haley, I heard about adaptive card and I know it's supposed to be wonderful. Can you explain a bit more what it is?
Sure, yeah. So an adaptive card is a way of, by not needing to know how to code or develop, you can create a UI within your application. So the idea is that you can define what a card is, so whether it's got any inputs, any buttons, any images, and then by not having to design a UI, you can then insert that definition into different applications such as Teams or Outlook actionable messages or Bot Framework, and there's many more. And the idea here is that you're having to design a single definition and it, irrespective of what application it's going to be hosted within. So if I create a form, I could, have what's your name, what's your email address, add a button to submit, and then I could effectively define that within a an adaptive card, and then I could then render that in Teams or whatever application. And but from the end user's perspective, it would look like a Teams application. It wouldn't look like something from a web page or something. The idea is that it looks native to the end user, and from a perspective of the person that creating the card, you don't have to know how to create a Teams UI or anything like that. So it's flexible, it's easy to develop with, and it's kind of one card, multiple applications.
Oh, that's how it get this name, adaptive, so it looked native. So you mentioned it's easy to design. Can we see it? Can we see how
Oh
you
yeah,
do that?
absolutely. Yeah, no, not a problem.
Let's bring your screen. Voila.
Okay, so yeah, so this is the adaptive cards designer. It's very good. It's a way of designing a card before you actually have to put it into an application or a flow, whatever you're going to be putting it into. And the beauty of it here is that you have the code or JSON document, really. It's not technically a language, and you can then define what is inside a card, and then the designer will then render it up here. In this case, as a Teams application, we could change it to a web chat conversation, and you'll notice the information is still the same, and the schema hasn't changed, but it's still a JSON schema. But what has changed is sort of the look and feel. It looks more like a web chat message rather than a Teams message. If we go back to Teams, it's the same information, it's just presented slightly differently. And if we just scroll this up a bit for a second, the idea here is that you can effectively modify and change items in here by templating. So if we've got, let's say, the flight number here, this is KL605. Now, if I on the right hand side, we have the data. This is the data that we're going to put in the card. The left hand side is the template, right hand side is the data. And by just modifying the data, the card then is updated to the reflect.
Oh, yeah, right away.
Yeah, right away, absolutely. And effectively, what happens here is we have some like dollar and sort of curly brackets, and that's effectively a template value. And then by just changing the data, it then updates the templates. So the idea is that you design a template for your application, and then you populate the data for that particular instance. So that's for this flight, but then for the next flight, it might be a different flight number, and it changes. And then if I just quickly go through to something a bit more straightforward to follow, we have a weather tracker here. So it gets the current weather for a particular location, and gives you a chance of rain and wind speed and as such. And again, we can change this to appear as a web chat message or a Cortana message or a Teams message. And this is the beauty of the designer, is that you can actually modify it within here. So if I say, actually, I want a text block at the bottom, and within that text block, I want to add some extra information, I can just put time of day, and then I can put things quicker. But the time of day, and just like that, you've added an extra component, and just like that, it will work in web chat or whatever host application you want to use. So we now
This
move on. Yeah.
is fantastic. So we have about 2 minutes. Can we see it in action? Can we see
Oh,
a snippet of the code maybe?
absolutely. So let's just quickly go through. So this is the actual same card that I had in the designer, but now it's showing within Teams. So if I mention weather and I just put in London.
So now it's calling a service that provide the data following the same structure we saw in the designer.
Exactly.
And now like your card is presenting it. That's brilliant. I love that.
Absolutely. So now that same card that we had in the designer is actually in the code in here.
Okay.
You don't need to be a coder. You could do it in Power Automate or some other method, but I'm just using code here. It's easier to kind of explain. And what we have here is we are grabbing the location that I mentioned. So I mentioned London. It's then picking through a UK public API to get the current weather for that location. It's then taking that location information, so what the high temperature is, what the low temperature is, the wind speed, all that information, and putting it into an adaptive card data. So that card data is the same as what was in the designer. It's effectively the same information.
The same structure, yeah.
Absolutely. And then using the same data structure, the same card definition, and then effectively what we're doing here is we're injecting that card data into the template, and then we're creating an adaptive card with that template that's got the injected data in, and then sending a message out to Teams.
That's wonderful, and that's easy. And you mentioned that there's different ways to do that. Today you presented using code, but it could be done with other alternative, correct?
Absolutely, yeah. And so there's obviously you can code it. You could use logic apps. You could use a Power Automate flow. So, you know, you don't have to rely on code. The idea is that you don't have to.
I love that. That's wonderful. Thank you for sharing all that. And now let's go see what our viewers have for questions.
Okay, thanks.